गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, हेयर टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन द वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट पार्ट. इट्स अ वेरी वट एवर आई एम गोइंग टू टीच यू, इट्स अ वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट मीन्स इट इज अबाउट एम्पलीट्यूड. यू कैन से एम्पलीट्यूड और आर्ग्यूमेंट. Means if our complex number is lie on the first quadrant, suppose here this point, okay, and the complex number in the this is your first quadrant, it's our modulus r, that is very easily to find out. And suppose here is a point p, okay, and this point every time give you the complex number. Actually we know very well a complex number will be lie on the argand plane, okay, and argument means theta is every time lie here, means it is anti-clockwise measurement from the positive direction of x-axis. If you want to write at a place, you can write anti-clockwise. I'm talking about only amplitude. What is the amplitude? Basically in my previous lecture you have seen, but I am repeating again, anti-clockwise measurement from the positive direction of x-axis, okay. Anti-clockwise direction means in this direction. So students, I'm going to give you some conditions here in this way, like if our complex number lie on the first quadrant and if it is lie on the second quadrant, for the third, okay, and the last one is fourth, that particular in this way. Here of course this is your modulus r and the theta, in which direction? Anti-clockwise direction, in this way, just like this angle is theta, and for third quadrant it is of course it is again theta, and the last one is theta. So the situation is like that, okay. If quadrant is if complex number lie in the first quadrant, in this way the theta, this is your amplitude, or you can say the argument. And here for the second quadrant, this is your argument, and for the third, in this way, like that. But students, matter is that suppose for this I am talking about for first figure it's very important, so I will my speed is very slow. For first figure you can see here complex number is lies on first quadrant, okay. So suppose theta is here 45 degree. I am taking the 45 degree. So students, listen very carefully, here theta is not only the 45 degree, okay. Here you can say theta means argument. Here theta is not, or you can say theta means argument. You can write here the argument, okay. This is argument, or you can say the amplitude. Argument is not only 45 degree, but you can imagine You can see here. Here it will be see my pen very carefully. It's a 2 pi, and 2 pi plus pi by 4, we will get the same complex number, means at 2 pi plus 45 degree, okay, you will get the same value, and 2 pi, it's a 3 pi and 4 pi, and 4 pi plus pi by 4, you will get again same value, okay. So this means we will get infinite. So we will, I am writing everything, okay, you can understand. It's not a matter, you will not write on your copy, okay? You should understand. We will get infinite argument. So I will restrict it. I will restrict it. Means I will speak here something in Hindi. Restrict means हम इसको थोड़ा सा close करेंगे, एक limit लगाएंगे, okay? Restriction for argument is, I am taking minus pi to pi, and here will be close interval, means I already explained to you, this theta will change in principal argument, this argument will change in principal argument, because there are many solutions means infinite argument, okay. In my I have already explained this thing in the trigonometric equation, where we are getting many solution, okay, then we restrict the solution by taking some conditions, okay. So that time the solution is called the principal solution. Similarly here the argument will be known as a principal argument, means so we can write here minus pi is less than theta is less than or equal pi, then theta is called theta is called principal argument. Is it clear? Then theta is what? Principal argument. It's a very important portion. Okay. So I am on the next phase, and this is very important phase. So means we will every time get what? Theta is less than pi, but less than or equal minus pi also, okay. So students, it's a minus pi and it's positive pi, okay. So students, see here, you can see from this figure here, I will make all the figures first, okay. Second, where the theta is, where the complex number is lie in the second quadrant, and the last, and not last one, it's a second last one, it's a third one, okay. And the last one is suppose here, I will take it. Yes, okay. So if your complex number lie in the first quadrant, it's a modulus r, and here will be the theta, okay. And the last one, not the last one, it's if complex number lie in the second quadrant, so it will be your argument theta. And if it is lying in which quadrant, if complex number is lying in the third quadrant, that will be your theta. And for the last one is, you can see here in the anticlockwise, according to the direction, according to the definition, theta is what? it's a anti-clockwise measurement from the positive direction of x-axis. So students, you can see here, you can generally find out very easily here the theta is by the tan theta. You can use this rule. Tan theta is what? It's a imaginary part of z. You can write in this way, imaginary part of z upon real part of z. Very easily for the first quadrant, you can find out in this way the what argument. And now the matter is what for second quadrant, if theta is lie, if complex number is lie in the second quadrant, then matter is what here? It is, of course, it is theta. Of course, here is theta. The complex number is what? Here the argument is theta. So students, listen very carefully. We will, of course, we know well the associated complex number for the second quadrant is what? Minus x plus I by, okay? And if you want to change in Cartesian form, it will be minus x comma y. Okay, it will be minus x comma y. But for the complex number, every time we have to represent it the argand plane, so it will be minus x plus I y. So students, we will take here, it's of course this angle is theta, but we don't know what is this angle. You can see this, we don't know what is, of course this is pi minus theta, this is pi minus theta, but I am taking a value. You can say I will find out a quantity here at this angle. I am taking for some time, it's a phi. I am taking what? It's a phi. So tan phi is what? What is the value of tan phi? Tan phi is, of course, this is minus x. It's a minus x. Actually, it is negative direction of x axis, and here is positive direction of y axis. Okay, so tan phi is what? Here we will get the negative value. You can see the imaginary part of z. Imaginary part of z is what? It's a here imaginary part of z is, this is by, okay? So and real part of z is minus x. So this, because of this minus x, we will apply here the modulus sign. It will be imaginary part of z upon real part of z in this way. Okay, so by this we will get the value what? Tan phi. So for actually we need to find out the theta. So theta is here, if you see very carefully, it's a theta plus phi for second. This is what for the second? Yes. So theta plus phi is what? It's a pi. Is it clear? So theta is what? Theta will be pi minus phi. So here students, we need to find out only what is the value of phi. What is the value of here? By this we can find out phi. Okay, generally what is the value? If you are finding out the value of phi, this means that is very easy to find out the theta. Theta will be pi minus phi. Okay, now students, I am on the third figure where the complex number is lie on the third quadrant. So students, see here, our theta is every time between minus pi to pi, but here you can see it is more than pi. Here it's 0 degree, it's a pi by 2, it is pi. But theta never will be, here you can see it's a theta which is greater than pi, but theta is never will be greater than pi. Okay, so we will change the direction because it is every time we can take the theta from minus pi to pi. Okay, so where will be? It's a 0. Okay, so this figure is cancelled because here the theta is greater than pi, and here for the where the complex number is lie on the fourth quadrant, you can see very easily this figure is also incorrect. Why it is incorrect? I will speak here again in Hindi. Here आप देख सकते हो यहाँ पर theta जो है वो क्या है आपका pi से, जो pi है इससे हमेशा ज़्यादा है, मगर यहाँ पर जो हमारी condition है, the condition from the principal argument, the theta should be every time the condition follow this condition, minus pi is less than theta is less than or equal pi. Okay, means theta never will be greater than pi. So this condition failed, and here it is also failed. Actually for this figure you can see the theta, this theta is also greater than, not a pi, it's also greater than 3 pi by 2. okay, so it is also cancelled. So what you will do for the complex number if lie on the third quadrant and for the fourth quadrant? So see very carefully, both the figures are wrong here due to condition. Okay, so I will make at this place here. Of course, this is your according to the condition, your theta is what? Minus pi is less than theta. I will write here again in this form. So students, that means of course this is 0, here is pi by 2, it's a pi. So students, for the clockwise direction, it will be minus pi by 2 and here will be minus pi. Okay, so we can take theta as from this direction, it will be negative theta. It is what? Negative theta. Is it correct? Here it will be, yes. So here, that is, of course, this is minus theta. Okay, in actually in the direction is here clockwise. So we will take the negative theta. And students, I am just asking to you again, what is this angle? This angle I am taking already, just like here, it's a phi. Okay, so generally we will find out in same manners. Tan phi is what? Tan phi is modulus of imaginary part object due to the negativity. Here that it will be negative direction and it will be also negative direction. Okay, so image, because of this I am using modulus sign. And why we are using modulus sign? Because we will every time get the positive value, so it is real part object. Is it clear? So in this way you can find out the phi, whatever the phi. So here this is what? Minus theta plus, it's a positive phi, is equal minus pi. Is it clear, students? It's a minus pi, or it's a here. So here, students, we can say the theta is I will write here the theta is minus pi plus phi. According to this, here theta should be, of course here is minus theta, but we are getting a theta, we need to change here the sign. It's a minus pi and it will be plus pi. If you are taking theta minus pi as a common, you will get a minus pi minus phi. Okay, so now students, it is for the third quadrant, and for the fourth, of course for the fourth is where this is for the third quadrant. If complex number lie in the third quadrant, and for fourth, this is also not very tough, it's very easy. Here the theta, if complex number is lie on the fourth quadrant, it will be minus theta. Okay, so this means it's, of course, for the first quadrant it is positive theta, it will be minus theta. So in this way you can find out here the theta every time. For the first quadrant, here the theta is, if you want to find out the theta as in form of phi, so it will be equal phi. And for the fourth quadrant, theta is equal minus phi. Is it clear? Okay, here the theta, actually whenever you will find out this minus theta is equal the positive phi. Actually, it's, I am taking the positive quantity here because of modulus sign. So theta is give you the negative of phi. Okay, because it is lie on the fourth quadrant. So this means I will make here the diagram for important condition. See here. Actually, I will explain for all. Here the theta is, you can write theta is equal phi. If you are finding tan phi, what? It's a modulus of imaginary part object upon real part of z. Okay, so here the theta is equal phi. For this, if complex number lie in the first quadrant, here that will be the theta. Okay, this is the point where the complex number lie in the first quadrant, here the theta is equal to phi. Okay, when I will solve some question, that time everything will be clear. For the second quadrant, here will be the theta. So that means here theta is every, if you are finding tan phi, so it is pi minus, here the theta is what, pi minus phi. Okay, in this way you can find out the phi. And for the third figure, if complex number lie in the third quadrant, so it will be minus theta, it will be minus, I will write here again minus theta. So here the theta is, students, I can tell you a short trick. If this is pi minus phi for the second quadrant, so here the theta is what, minus bracket pi minus phi, you can write in this way. Okay, and for the fourth quadrant, of course this is minus theta. Okay, so here the minus theta means theta should, it's a positive phi, so for the fourth quadrant theta should be minus phi. This is the main thing. Okay, in this way you will find out the argument, because the theta should be from here to here, all the figures here theta is every time minus pi, is less than theta, is less than or equal pi. Okay students, in this way you will solve. Now I will take here a question. By this question everything will be clear. So students, I am taking a three question. First is, represent the complex number z is equal 1 plus root 3 I. It's your first complex number. Z is equal 2 minus 2i. It's your second complex number. And the last one is third. It's 1 plus 7i upon 2 minus I to the whole square. In polar form, we have to change these complex number in polar form. What is the polar form? Where z should be equal r into cos theta plus I sine theta. This is the polar form. It is called the polar form of any complex number. Here the z is what, x plus iy, means we can change the complex number x plus iy in form of r into cos theta plus I sine theta. So this form is known as a polar form. Where students, we need a number first, argument. Okay, this theta is argument, not argument, it's a principal argument. Okay, it's a principal argument. And here it is, r is what, modulus. This r gives you the modulus. So I will take the first question. First is, here the z is 1 plus root 3 into I. So students, let me clear, at first this complex number lie in which quadrant? Here the real part of z is positive and the imaginary part of z is also positive. Here you can write, here the real part of z is what, real part of z is 1, means it's a positive. Okay, and after that, real part means it is related to the x-axis. Okay, and the imaginary part of z, which is imaginary part of z, is root 3. So this is also positive, means it's for the imaginary axis, it's a biaxis. So real part of z is positive, imaginary part of z, both are the positive. This means it will lie on which quadrant? The complex number will lie in first quadrant. Here is 1 plus root 3i. Is it clear? And this plane is called argument plane. So yes, at first we want to take what we need, modulus. Here r is what, you know very well, it will be real part of z to the whole square plus imaginary part of z to the whole square. This is a formula, previously I told to you. Okay, here this r, okay, we are finding right now this r. Okay, and the angle is theta, or you can write it's a phi. Okay, so students, here real part of z is, of course this is 1 to the whole square plus imaginary part of z is root 3, this is whole square. So this thing, it's a 1 to the whole square is 1 plus root 3 to the whole square is 3. This means it is 2. Okay, of course we are done. It's a modulus is clear. Okay, R we know very well. This is what? 2. So now students, we will work for the argument. This is very important argument. Here, every time you will find out the 10, 5 first. Okay, and then you will check, of course, this 5 for the first quadrant here, 5 should be equal theta. Okay, so means sorry, you can write here the theta is equal 5 or 5. You, of course, I should not speak sorry, both are same. Okay, so argument 10 5 is what this is. We will apply here the modulus sign for finding phi, it should be every time positive quantity. Okay, so real part of z. It should be, listen, wait, here it is, no, it's an imaginary part of Z, imaginary part of Z upon real part of Z. You are thinking, how can I convert it? Listen, student, if this angle is phi, suppose that for some time it is, of course, it is theta, no issue. Okay, so 10 theta is what? Perpendicular upon base. Okay, so perpendicular is what? It's an imaginary part of it. Actually, it is parallel to y-axis. Okay, and it's this axis is called imaginary. So because of this, I am writing here imaginary part of Z and upon base. Base is real part of. Actually, it is from x-axis every time. So imaginary part of Z, you can see what is the imaginary part? It's root 3 upon real part of Z is 1. Okay, and both are the positive, already positive, so there is no matter of this modulus sign. So 10 phi is, we are getting 10 phi what? Root 3. And 10 phi root 3 means 10 60, of course it is 60. So phi is 60 degree, or you can write pi by 3. So this means then argument is what, students? Argument is pi by 3, means this is the value of theta, and here the theta is equal every time phi, means it is pi by 3. So polar form is what is the polar form? Here you can see from here Z is equal R. What is the value of R? R is 2, bracket cos theta is pi by 3. So you will write pi by 3 here. Plus, see my with this finger, plus I sine pi by 3. Okay, first question completed. See very carefully all the parts. Now students, I am going to solve the next question, which is Z is equal to minus 2i. Okay, so here I am asking to you, what is the, you can change here, the real part of Z. You can write here x plus I pi. Okay, so it's a 2 minus 2i, means real part of Z means x. I am talking to you for the LHS side, what is the real part of Z? This is x. And what is the real part of Z for second, you can say the RHS? It is of course 2. Okay, and imaginary part of Z, this is what, here it is positive. And here pi is what? It's a minus 2, of course, means it is negative. So students, will you tell me, it is this complex number associated in which quadrant? It will, it's a x is positive, pi is negative, x is positive, pi is negative, here is x is positive, here is negative positive, here negative, but here of course your complex number will be lie on this quadrant, means fourth quadrant. And fourth quadrant, we know very well theta is equal, tell me, theta is equal minus 5 for the fourth quadrant. You can see from the concept. Okay, so finally here we will find out the r is what, real part of Z. Now I will write directly real part of Z, it's a 2 to the whole square plus, and it is also minus 2 to the whole square. So this thing will give you 2 to the whole square, 4 plus minus 2 to the whole square, 4 plus 4, this is 8, or you can add 2 root 2. Okay, is it clear? So now we will work for the argument. Here the argument, here we will find out the 10 phi. Okay, 10 phi, every time we will find out the 10 phi. and then after some time the theta should be equal minus pi. Okay, you can see this is very important part of the concept here. Tan phi is what? Modulus of, you can write here for argument. Okay, means you are finding phi because of argument. So tan phi is what? Imaginary part of z upon real part of z. So imaginary part of z here is what? It's a minus 2, and real part of course this is 2. Is it clear? So here we will get the which type of value we are getting? Modulus of minus 1, and modulus of minus 1 every time is what, students? It's a you can tell here that it's a 1. And if tan phi is 1, this means it is tan pi by 4. So here phi is what? It's a pi by 4. So actually I need a theta. Theta means theta should be equal minus phi. From here theta is minus phi, so this means theta, your argument, your amplitude, actually argument and amplitude both are the same. Argument theta is equal minus phi is equal minus pi by 4. Okay, so your polar form is what? R is z is equal r into cos theta plus I sine theta. So r is what? What is the value of r? This is 2 root 2. Take it, cos theta is minus pi by 4 plus I sine minus pi by 4. Is it clear, everyone? In this way you will get the solution of the second part. If you want to take the screenshot, you can take the screenshot in this way. The student, main thing is what? We need to identify where the complex number is lying, in which quadrant. Okay, and now I am going to give you a homework. Write down the homework. Third part is your homework. And what is the third part? I will give you here the hint. It is 1 plus 7i upon 2 minus I to the whole square. You will change it in form, at first convert it in form of a plus ib. Okay, then you will get the polar form. I will also tell you here how will you change it in form of a plus I by. Listen, it's a z is equal, here is 1 plus 7i, no issue of course, but here is 2 minus I to the whole square. Will you open it? Of course, a minus b, it is looks like a minus b to the whole square. So this is what? A means 2 to the whole square is 4, plus I to the whole square is I am writing here I square, minus 2 into AB, A for 2, B for I. So we are getting 1 plus 7i upon 4 and positive I square. So positive I square, this means minus I square is minus 1. So we are getting minus 1, and here minus 2 to the 4i. So this is minus 4i. So finally, students, we are getting 1 plus 7i upon 4 minus 1, this is 3. And 3, and it's a minus 4i. Okay, so in this way, 1 plus 7i upon 3 minus 4i. Now students, can you tell me here it is a plus ib form? No, we will rationalize again. Actually first time we are rationalized, not again. So rationalize means it will be, we will multiply the rationalized denominator, it will be 3 plus 4i upon 3 plus 4i. So again we will multiply, 1 multiply with the 3. So students, I need a space. Here we have not a space. Okay, we will move for here. Yes, this thing is better. Yes, in this way you can check. It's a 1 plus 7i. Yes, 1 multiply with the 3, this is 3. We are right now finding z. Okay. 1 multiply by 3, 3. 1 multiply with the 4i, positive 4i. So this is positive 4i. 7i multiply with the 3i plus 21i. And 7i multiply with the 4i. 7, 4 is 28. Means it will be plus 28 I to the power 2. Actually, I multiply with I. This is I square upon. Here, students, you can see it is looks like A minus B, A plus B. So this is A square minus B square. 3 to the whole square minus D is what? 4I to the whole square. So we are getting what? 3I, 3, and actually it's a minus 28 because due to I square. Okay. So 3 minus 28 is what? Minus 25. Okay, and 21i and plus 4i, this is plus 25i upon here it's a 9 and it's a 4, of course this is a it's a 9 and minus 4i means 16i square means it will be positive 16. Okay, because we are getting here 16i square and I square is minus 1, so because of this minus 1 multiply with the minus 1, this will plus 16. Okay, so students, we are getting what? Minus 25 plus 25 I upon 16 plus 9, 25. Or students, we can write in this way, minus 25 upon 25 plus 25 I upon 25. This means minus 25 upon 25 minus 1 plus I. So it is converted, of course. Here we are getting z is equal minus 1 plus I. Okay, and this form is called a plus ib form, or you can write x plus I by form. Okay, means we need to convert it in form of complex number. So tell me, what is x, what is by here, what is the real part of z? Is real part of z is minus 1, imaginary part of z is also 1, positive. So here it's a negative and it's a positive, so it's your work. Now tell me, in which quadrant it is lie? X is negative and y is positive. X is in this quadrant. Thanks for watching. Take care. Bye bye. Okay, and all the very best for your next paper, for your future papers. Okay.